In a surprising turn of events that caught many by surprise, Blue Origin unexpectedly grabbed the spotlight with NASA's announcement of the company's Lunar Lander launch strategy. It was truly remarkable, and trust me, the timeline will leave you speechless. However, that's not the point. Blue Origin strategically prepared for a major launch with New Glenn, laying the foundation for a bold and ambitious future. How bold is their upcoming strategy? Will their trajectory be as smooth as anticipated? Let's dive in on today's episode of NR Studio. After your flight day in January, you may have found yourself contemplating the current state of Blue Origin. The silence surrounding the company has been somewhat unusual. With the exception of their suborbital vehicle, New Shepard, one must consider that the company is currently conducting an investigation into the New Glenn booster incident while simultaneously developing hardware for the upcoming flight. As a result, amidst the lack of news, interest in Blue Origin has waned. However, it appears that NASA has recently revealed an important update regarding Blue Origin, specifically regarding their Blue Shepard Moon Mark 1 spacecraft. This insight came from a slide presented during the Lunar and Planetary Science Conference 2025. The slide listed upcoming lunar spacecraft missions scheduled for 2025 and 2026. To everyone's surprise, Blue Origin appeared at the top. This indicated that they were ready to begin their launch earlier than all other entities on the list, with a target date set for August 2025. Indeed, Blue Origin's Blue Moon Mark 1 spacecraft is set to launch in just 5 months. This revelation is quite surprising, especially considering how little we've been told about the spacecraft since it was first introduced. If all goes according to plan, this will mark the third U.S. lunar spacecraft to launch this year, ahead of Astrobotics Griffin Mission, which is scheduled to fly on a Falcon Heavy later this year. Other efforts on the agenda include the anticipated deployment of an intuitive machines lander in early 2026. The company recently unveiled IM-2, which includes two Firefly Aerospace missions scheduled for mid-2026, along with a Blue Ghost lander and a Draper lander anticipated for late 2026. The decision to launch ahead of companies with established lunar expertise, such as Astrobotics, Intuitive Machines, and Firefly, underscores Blue Origin's unwavering commitment to its lunar aspirations. Of course, as Blue Origin gains public attention, it's inevitable that comparisons to SpaceX will arise. To date, SpaceX's contributions to lunar exploration have primarily involved providing launch vehicles, not landers. The upcoming Starship HLS Lunar Lander has been engineered for crewed lunar landings. However, its maiden launch is not expected to be earlier than 2027. While this is not a direct comparison, given that Starship and Blue Moon have different roles, Blue Origin can still take pride in being the first entity to successfully land its own spacecraft on the lunar surface. In the long run, developing a functional lunar lander will give Blue Origin important experience in preparation for Artemis 5, which is the mission they aim to land astronauts on the moon. However, this raises an important question. Will this mission prove to be as easy as it sounds? Unlike other companies that rely on SpaceX for launches, Blue Origin plans to propel its lander using its own New Glenn rocket, which has had some major issues. New Glenn successfully completed its maiden flight earlier this year. However, there have been no major updates regarding the upcoming mission since that milestone. After a booster malfunction during its maiden flight, the company continues to investigate the issue, which is expected to delay additional launches as it awaits approval for a new launch license. Furthermore, Blue Origin is managing an additional delayed NASA mission, Escapade, which was originally scheduled for last year. NASA has given New Glenn authorization to conduct this mission. However, with Escapade and Blue Moon Mark 1 dependent on the rocket's performance, the success of this effort hinges on New Glenn actually being ready for operational readiness. In addition to these two goals, Blue Origin has an extensive launch schedule that is coming up on New Glenn. The excitement surrounding the unexpected arrival of the Blue Moon Mark 1 is undeniably significant. However, one fact remains clear. Blue Origin still has quite a journey ahead of them. Will they be able to execute their plans, or will technical delays hinder their progress? As for the Blue Moon Mark 1 lunar lander, its progress is still shrouded in secrecy behind the confines of Blue Origin's manufacturing facility. Is it truly finalized? If the organization sincerely intended to launch in August, the lander should have been completed and advanced into the testing phase by now. Reliability is paramount, especially considering recent lunar lander failures such as Japan's sleek and intuitive IAM-2 and Astrobotics Peregrine. However, no updates have been released. While Blue Origin's aspirations for lunar exploration seem bold, their readiness for the upcoming August mission remains questionable. What's your perspective? Do you anticipate Blue Origin will successfully launch the Blue Moon Lunar Lander in August? Let us know with a simple yes or no in the comments section below. Also, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel to stay updated on SpaceX's exciting journey into the cosmos. That pretty much sums up Blue Origin's lunar endeavors. However, let's now explore their broader aspirations, which were recently revealed. During the Air and Space Force Association's War Conference in Aurora, Colorado, on March 3rd, Blue Origin CEO Dave Limb articulated some ambitious projections regarding the company's upcoming launch initiatives. Early on, he alluded to the sheer magnitude of the upcoming launch initiatives. "I'm sure many people may underestimate the number of significant rocket launches anticipated in the next 5 to 8 years." He confidently asserts, "We're going to launch a bunch of launches, successfully retrieve our boosters, and then repeat the process." That sentiment strikes a very familiar chord, doesn't it? Blue Origin clearly aspires to deploy New Glenn in a similar manner to SpaceX, their primary rival and the prevailing pioneer in the high-frequency reusable rocket launch domain. Jeff Bezos has previously articulated that Blue Origin aspires to achieve 25 launches per year in the future. If all goes well, that number could potentially increase even further. Their goal goes beyond just frequent launches. It embodies reusability, as evidenced by their efforts to land New Glenn boosters on a drone ship during its maiden flight. What underlies the urgency for rapid launches and reusability? It's primarily because of Blue Origin's significant commitments to meet. Initially, they must rely on New Glenn to facilitate Amazon's Kuiper broadband satellite constellation, which is a direct competitor to SpaceX's Starlink. Given that Amazon and Blue Origin were founded by Bezos, the success of New Glenn has a direct bearing on Kuiper's competitive position. Limp underscores this idea by asserting that additional mega constellations are anticipated. Governments will need additional resources. Civil space will need additional resources. "I foresee a future landscape characterized by multiple launches every day, but I believe we have not sufficiently considered the infrastructure required to support such activity. We have not strategized for that scenario." In addition to its efforts with Kuiper, Blue Origin has been awarded numerous contracts with government and military entities. It has been selected for Phase 3 of the U.S. Space Force's National Security Space Launch Program, which will continue through the late 2020s and requires a tight but adaptable launch schedule. Furthermore, let's not overlook NASA's Artemis program. Blue Origin is tasked with facilitating a lunar landing for astronauts during the Artemis 5 mission, projected for 2029. Increasing launch frequency and increasing reusability are critical to ensuring New Glenn's reliability ahead of this important mission. To achieve these ambitions, Blue Origin faces a significant workload ahead. Internally, there is a pressing need to speed up their process. The previous year had been devoted exclusively to hardware preparation and testing. However, a new launch occurred in January. At the current rate, achieving 25 launches per year is a huge challenge. Realizing even just 5 launches per year is a significant challenge. Currently, the most significant production constraint lies with the BE engine, which is also the propulsion behind ULA's Vulcan rocket. The concurrent demand increases the need for rapid production. However, speed alone is not enough to overcome the challenge. They must also ensure reliability, especially considering the previous year's report of failures in the New Glenn upper stage during testing for its second and third flights. In order to achieve their goals, it is imperative that testing be conducted with greater frequency and increased efficiency. They cannot afford to have long intervals between assessments, and the development of additional test beds will facilitate their increased operational capacity. In terms of flight performance, Blue Origin must quickly identify and fix any issues stemming from New Glenn's maiden flight. To avoid delays, it is imperative to make early improvements and refinements. This will take a significant amount of time and effort from the Blue Origin team. Even if these issues are resolved, the competitive landscape remains fierce. Currently, SpaceX holds a dominant lead in the industry with its Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets, which significantly outperform Blue Origin. Even SpaceX's newest rocket, Starship, has already surpassed New Glenn in launch frequency. While it is highly unlikely that they will ever surpass SpaceX, it is worth noting that other competitors continue to make progress. ULA, Rocket Lab, and various other aerospace companies are making significant progress, requiring Blue Origin to carefully formulate its strategy to remain competitive in this dynamic landscape. The coming months are shaping up to be crucial for Blue Origin. Their aspirations are ambitious, especially with the imminent launch of a lunar lander scheduled for the coming months. Their advocacy for regular reusable New Glenn flights is equally ambitious. If they succeed, it would be a major milestone for Bezos, Limp, and their team. However, the obstacles remain significant. They must accelerate the operationalization of New Glenn, provide concrete updates on the lunar lander, and ramp up their efforts to meet tight contractual deadlines in the future. Will Blue Origin rise to the occasion and establish a more formidable presence in the industry? That's it for today's episode. See you in the next one, and thank you for your support.